What's up, people? Welcome back to yet another one. This one is a bit different. It's going to be kind of like a special video, I would say. It's not more of like a review, it's more of a discussion. And then in today's video, we'll be talking about these kind of like heavy, well, not heavy, kind of like depends on the case, but these blow molded case, which is kind of like you see them all over like eBay and Amazon, specialized tools. In this case, this one is a front wheel bearing remover and installer kit over here. Obviously, you got your different adapters, your sleeves and all of that, but you get the idea. Specialized tools, whether it's like this, or as you can see in the picture over here and here, which is kind of like slide hammer or kind of like a bearing splitter or something like that, bearing splitter or separator or something like that, ball joint removers. And, you know, there's all sorts of specialized tools out there. And, you know, the conversation is it worth investing in these types of tools? Now, there's a couple of reasons, but, you know, number one thing, like, if you're working as, like, on a main dealer, probably they're going to have these tools, so you might not be as tempted to get these tools, because main dealer, they're going to have the specialized tools, whatever you need. If you are working in an independent shop, you know, don't get me wrong, there are independent shops that, you know, they have like loads of specialized tools, and you know those shops, you know, they do good business, they're proper shops. There's other shops that, you know, they don't have specialized tools, so you kind of like, you need to figure like you need to figure a way out to get the job done and things like that. You know, my previous work, you know it had some specialized tools like a presser and all of that. It didn't have anything like this though, so which is more straightforward to the job. And you know, there's three main reasons why I would like advise investing in tools like this. Not necessarily this one, other specialized tools like I mentioned, slide hammer, anything of that nature, ball joint removers, different specialized tools. Number one is going to be the health reason. Now, obviously, as a mechanic, it is a stressful job. There's no lying about that. Whether you're doing something like, you know, no, I mean, if you're doing servicing and anything like light stuff like that, it's not like really that hard. Obviously, you need the knowledge, but I'm talking about more of a, like, if you're doing bigger jobs, like let's say, for instance, bearings, something more complicated and heavy, like clutch job and anything of that nature, you know, you do need to use your manpower to, like, you know, get the job done. So it is stressing to the body. And then there's times when you need to, like, you got to seize things and then you need to hammer them out and yada yada yada, you know, like hammering something for half hour straight or whatever because it's so seized. Everyone has been there, no denying that. You know, you're trying to get to lunch, you're trying to get the job done at the same time, and that thing is seized solid, and you know, you gotta keep hammering it till it, you know, pops out or something like that, whether it's like a ball joint or, you know, lower arms or whatever the, you know, whatever it might be, anything. But yeah, you get what I'm saying. So as I mentioned, number one is going to be health reason. Me, I'm, you know, no one to talk in terms of experience, because there's a lot of other people that have been in the industry more than me, 15, 20, 30 years, 40 years. So me, you know, I've got like X amount of years, let's say kind of like 3-4 in the industry, but let's say some other years before that. But anyway, let's say like roughly like 5 years or so, you know, I'm not one to talk, but, you know, talking to like other, like older generation mechanics, the conversation, like the subject does come up of like, oh, you know, like my elbows hurt, my shoulders hurt, kind of like, you know, my body aches, my knees and all of that. Because it is a stressful job and it will get to you at some point, you know, you do put your body through stress, and it's tools like these that kind of like make the job obviously more, you know, easier, number one thing, more efficient, and like in terms of time consuming and that, and it makes it more easier to you as an individual when you're working. I mean, what you rather do, use a ball joint separator or, you know, use a hammer to like take out the ball joint? Yes, sometimes you get lucky, you know, the things come apart easy. But other times the proper C solid in there, and then, you know, you're like in real trouble, like in terms of like, hey, the job done. It's gonna be like, you know, one of those jobs like, you know, you kind of like, ah, oh, jeez. But anyway, investing in tools like this, you know, in the long term, you're gonna feel it is gonna be beneficial for your own health, especially if you're someone like me, or you know, like I'll do power building, so I go to the gym and lift weights and do that and other things. So I do like stress my body even more. So you know, and then if you're not getting enough sleep, I don't know, you know, what your case of scenario way is, but yeah, that's gonna add up to, you know, your health, which is the most important thing. Now it makes more sense because obviously everyone as a mechanic, you know, you get a paycheck, you got a life to live, you got bills to pay. It makes sense, like, you know, getting, you know, let's say ratchets or spanners or sockets or whatever, something that you know you're gonna be using on a daily basis is more logic, because that you're gonna be using, like, I would say 90, 95% of the time on a daily basis, no questioning that. But you know, thinking about investing in something like this, it will make a difference, trust me. Now, number two is gonna be kind of like, if you're thinking, I mean, let's say at the moment you're working at a shop, like let's say main dealer, independent, whatever the case might be, and then you're thinking, you know, you wanna do your own thing, kind of like, you know, your own, open up your own shop, or you know, if you can afford that, you're thinking more of like a mobile mechanic sort of thing. So, you know, if you already invested in tools like these, it kind of like gives you more confidence, like, okay, you know, because if you go mobile mechanic or you open your own shop, you know, whatever tools you have, that's the tools you have. So, you know, whatever you invested in your toolbox, you know what jobs you can do and what jobs you can do. So it kind of like gives you more confidence, like, okay, I got these tools, I can do this job, I can do this job. I got this special tool for, like, let's say the, for instance, this one, you know, if I want to do a bearing, I know I got the tool, I can do the job easy, no problem. Because, you know, you're thinking up this when you're taking up jobs. Because the last thing you want to do is you want to take up a job, you're halfway through, and then you realize, ah, oh, you know, I'm stuck, this tool, or I'm gonna need this tool, or the thing is like sea solid or whatever, or I need the special tool to get this thing out, that's the only way. You know, you can invent your own special tools and stuff like that, but you get what I'm saying. This is a more straightforward thing. You know, you're gonna go there, you know, in terms of like, compared to like hammering the shit out of it for like half hour straight, this one, I would say a third of the time easily. So, you know, that's the second reason. Like, if you're thinking of, you know, doing your own thing, if you're already invested in these, it kind of gives you a bit more confidence, kind of like making that choice, because you already got a good like foundation and setup of tools. The third reason is kind of like, I would say more personal, but I believe there's tons of people that are like just like me, which is kind of like, I don't really like to borrow tools. I mean, obviously, yeah, if it's a specialized tool, at some point, you know, if you don't have it, yeah, I understand of borrowing it, but I'm kind of like, I want to be that kind of like independent guy. I know I have the tool, I can do the job. I don't like to, like, you know, look for the tool in the shop. You know, some workshops, you know, they're organized, you know where the tools are, so you know, you go to the toolbox or whatever, and then you pick up the tool. Other situations, other garages, you know, the tools might be all over the place. Or let's say, like, I want to grab this tool, I want to do a bearing, and then, you know, I'm like, okay, let me go pick up the tool from the shop, and then you go there, and then maybe like this adapter is missing, and then, or this sleeve is missing, and then you spend like, I don't know, like 15, 20 minutes looking for, you know, the tool around the shop or the adapter. So, you know, for me, I don't like that. I like to be independent. You know, I know where this is gonna be in my toolbox. You know, I go to my toolbox, get the tool, do the job, put it back, job done. That, I mean, that's me, but I feel like there is a big majority of number of people that like are the same as me. You know, you want to be independent, have your own tools, you know, to do the job. Like I said, there's always going to be like a times that, you know, you might not have the tool, you know. Obviously, tools cost money, you're not gonna have all the specialized tools. So in those cases, yeah, it is what it is, you know, you need to borrow the tool. But yeah, that's pretty much the video in general. I might do a review on this, see how it is, but you get the idea. I mean, these are kind of like, I would say simple setup, blow motor cases, specialized tools, you can see them everywhere. Are they worth it? I would say in the long run, I would say yes for the above reasons. Tell me what you guys people think, if you agree or disagree with this, in, you know, obviously in your own experience as well. You know, you leave a comment down below, you know, like if you had the same thoughts as me, and you know what ideas or what opinions you guys have. And I'll see ya in the next video. Peace.